Level 15, spikes. Surely enough, the first thing that calls for our attention in this level is a pit of sharp spikes, which we neutralize neatly and permanently by pressing a single, conveniently placed button to extend a sturdy causeway over the environmental hazard. Further to the right, as you might have predicted, is another pit of spikes, this time accompanied by a fire-spitting turret and a block bound to the ceiling by a chain. Even though we have damaged one link, the block remains in place. We need to apply a little bit more pressure, and what better way to do so than with gravity? The tricky, although unnecessary part was to jump off the block before plummeting alongside it. The block fell on a pressure plate, the spikes sank back into the floor, the fireballs ceased to emerge from the dreadful statue. Onwards! You might suspect Spike's head. This is not going to be the case. Wait a minute. Is there a secret passage to the left? How could I have missed that? Either way, the weapon of the pikeman could be construed to consist of a portable spike. That much I will admit. Taking care of them in an elegant way, now that I think about it, may be easier than it seems. Although it does take precise timing, and once they get past Olaf's shield, I tend to panic somewhat. I am of course aware of the fact that you could simply send Baliok down, avoid their attacks and kill them with carefully timed arrows, but as elegant as that seems, I prefer the safer approach of getting at least temporary assistance. Breaking the wall to the right, while almost certainly possible, is not something I wish to attempt. I see how it could be done, however. You put Olaf to the far right next to the wall, break the wall down with Eric, and immediately move Olaf to the right to confine the pikeman under the low ceiling. Now that you know it, you don't have to see it. We have plenty of pikemen ahead as it is. See? Three well-timed shots. That's the way to do it. The one above us should be easier to take care of. We have the low ceiling to thank for that. The plan here is simple. Ascend, block him, get rid of him. The novelty comes with the monsters in this game having peripheral vision, something I've already mentioned in some previous video. You can't just go up as soon as they turn their back, they will just turn around and kill you. I miss one shot, but not the three following ones. Up here we are facing falling blocks, and the remaining buttons are waiting to be pressed. Next to the buttons are symbols. The code we need is in the lower right corner. It is Spider Ankh Scales Eye. I flip the bottom right symbol to the eye, the upper left to the spider, get hurt on my way because I'm impatient, here's the Ankh, there are the scales, we push the final button and the exit route is clear. For a level called Spikes, there were relatively few of them, don't you think? Great work, guys! Yeah, what teamwork!
Maybe we'll get called up to the majors.